So welcome to Otokar stand. Welcome to our home city, Istanbul. We are honored to welcome all the delegations here. IDEF started in 1993. So as Otokar, we've been all participating all those years. This year in Otokar, we have lots of different products here. The new ones, the ones in service, and all the important family members, the portfolio of the products, we try to display here and show our capabilities to the delegations. Here we display around 10 vehicles, from starting 4x4s, 6x6, 8x8, and the track versions, and some of the variants of those. So we are honored to welcome our guests and show our capabilities here. Here in IDEF, we also display our Tulpar medium tank. This is a 35 to 40 ton class medium tank. This type of platform is a medium tank. And some of the countries use this configuration as an infantry fire support vehicle. So Tulpar platform is capable of doing whatever that mission requires. So here in this configuration, we have Tulpar on top. CMI's 105 millimeter turret with autoloader. So it has a two-man turret and can be capable of firing all types of 105 millimeter NATO ammunition. Driver, the road speed is 78 kilometers per hour with a range of 700 kilometers. It runs on diesel fuel and the water wading depth is 1.2 meters. The trench crossing capability, since we have 7 road wheels, the trench crossing capability is 2.5 meters, which provides also a good soft soil capability due to long track width. So the AKREP II here, doing the first public debat this year in IDEF. It's a three-man crew, gunner, driver and the commander, reconnaissance platform. But the power pack here we display is all electric. So the configuration of the vehicle is all power pack is at the back, and the electric batteries and the inverter and the drive system, power electronics, are at the rear of the vehicle. The crew sits in the empty center portion of the vehicle, and there is a bonnet in front of it. So the vehicle is capable of carrying up to 9 millimeter turrets, which is a good payload for this size of a vehicle. The design of the vehicle is with low silhouette. The top deck is 1.8 meters, and with the electrical design, the acoustic signature, thermal signature is minimized. We will use this AKREP platform, the electrical version, as a technology demonstrator, and we will pave our way from autonomous vehicles using the technologies that we have in this platform. This is a full electric vehicle. The existing configuration that we have here is capable of supporting the vehicle for most of the vehicles functioning about 200 kilometers range with the existing batteries. However, the battery sizes, the battery pack, can be doubled using the front stowage, and this can be increased according to the mission profile. The battery pack is a quick change one, so in the field a fully charged battery can be changed at a very quick time, so that its fully charged batteries can continue with the full mission. URAL is a lightweight armored vehicle, 4x4 vehicle, which is a cost-effective solution for armoring needs. It is, again, a conventional front-engined automatic transmission vehicle. Since it's lightweight, it has a very nice high power-to-weight ratio, and it is a very nice, good performer in cross-country. URAL is designed to be a paramilitary vehicle, and it's in service with the Turkish Gendarmerie, Turkish Police, and also in 4 different export customers with different configurations as well, like APC or patrol car or a command car for paramilitary usages. So URAL, we continue the same production for export customers this year as well. And we, depending upon their requirements, we do lots of variants using URAL platform. It is designed for a special requirement from one of our already existing clients for URAL. It's a special operations vehicle. We call it URAL SOV. So it has an open top vehicle. The waistline of the vehicle is same as URAL, but on the upper structure it carries a rotating race ring 0.50, front facing 7.62, rear facing 7.62 machine guns. It is designed for special operations vehicle, and will have lots of payloads according to their mission requirements. So basically, it's a whole vehicle designed for special forces. COBRA I is one of the most successful products of Otokar. We introduced COBRA the vehicle in 1997 and still continuing the production. Until now, we had produced nearly 5,000 vehicles of COBRA vehicle with different configurations. And it's in service with, of course, Turkish Army, Turkish Gendarmerie and Police. On top, it's in service in 20 countries in 25 users. So it's a worldwide, widespread vehicle, known for its performance and reliability and successful field performance. Having tapped on COBRA, we updated COBRA with COBRA II. COBRA II is the successor of COBRA vehicle, which we launched 4 years ago. And now it's in service with Turkish Army, Gendarmerie, and in five different countries with five different users, export customers. It's also available in troop carrier, patrol, ambulance, recovery, and command versions. The current customer portfolio admires the performance of COBRA II. The major differences of COBRA to COBRA I comes from mostly on protection and more technology inside. The vehicle has CAN bus and Vectronic system on the electronics, and the protection is nearly three times much than a COBRA. We also have the amphibious version as of COBRA I. Both are monocoque vehicles, meaning unitized steel hull with the engine front and other subsystems at the back. However, the weight, gross combat weight, plus the axle capacities are nearly three times much heavier than COBRA I. The COBRA II is capable of carrying up to 20 millimeter remote controlled stations, guns with 20 millimeter. The usual configuration is 12.7 millimeter remotely controlled weapon stations, or air defense variants, or anti-tank missile launchers. The ambulance version is the first time in a show, this time in IDEF. Actually, this vehicle is in service with Turkish Army and in one of our export customers. But we wanted to show the vehicle as well in this IDEF. We call this vehicle as Medical Evacuation vehicle. So it's a type of field ambulance, which is good for carrying two stretchers on board, or one stretcher to sitting patients with a jump seat for the medic. This is at the rear, and it has two man crew in the front. So it is equipped with lots of field kits, oxygen and medical surgery kits, field surgery kits, for the first intervention of wounded in the field. The protection level is the identical as of COBRA II. Due to the medical equipment and the environment of intervention, the rear body is slightly larger in height and width when compared to COBRA, but the protection is the same. Arma is a multi-wheel platform vehicle, armored vehicle. We have 6x6, 8x8 versions. So it's a band starting from 17 tons up to 32 tons. It's a big range. So in Arma range, the family of vehicles can cater for lots of different visions, missions of an infantry armored corps. So basically, the Arma family provides a high ballistic protection. On top, it provides an amphibious capability as well, depending upon the customer requirements. So here we display Arma 8x8 in Mızrak infantry fighting vehicle configuration. This is a 8x8, which is non-amphibious and compromising a remote control turret with 30 millimeter. It has 8 dismounts and 3-man crew as the gunner, operator, and the commander. Arma 6x6 is also displayed here in a command and control variant, where it has three different radios and 4-man crew. Arma here is a command and control version. it compromises a basket type, not remote control, basket type 25 millimeter turret with a coaxial 7.62 machine gun. So it is used as a command car and also uses a support, there's a support weapon of 25 millimeters. This is Tulpar-S. It is displayed here as an APC version and a 7.62 RCWS for self-defense purposes. The RCWS 7.62 millimeter machine gun can be replaced with 0.50 machine gun if required. So it has a self-protection needs and basic APC, which is can be used for amphibious missions as well. Actually, Otokar vehicles, some of the Otokar vehicles are here. It covers a wide range of vehicles from wheel to tracked, from 6 tons up to 40 tons. And our current customers, users, are proud of our vehicles. They are happy with the field success, with the performance and the reliability of the vehicles. And we have a good proven track record. So, Otokar, we see ourselves as a systems house providing any type of land defense solutions within one umbrella. So for the potential users, we can say that we can provide a good proven reliability, a protected reliability platforms for every type of need of a land defense requirement.